my name is Sylvia Schmeichel and I work at the National Museum of Natural History with Smithsonian Gardens. Habitat is an exhibit that runs throughout the entirety of our campus, our 13 gardens that span the National Mall. We have a number of different people on our staff that came up with this idea that was like, hey, how can we draw people into our exhibits that already exist and tell them what a diverse and important role that pollinators have in our world, in our gardens, and in our food sources.
I am Holly Walker, and my position here is I am the plant health specialist. My role for the Habitat exhibition was to be a consultant. My background specifically is biology and entomology, so it allowed me to add scientific content to the panels, to the projects themselves.
My name's Casey Kate, and I'm a gardener here at Natural History. This garden really shows and represents the importance of pollinators and how important they are to us as humans, since they produce 35% of the food we eat. So we're showing that we need to provide habitat and homes for them.
Pollinators are typically insects that help move pollen from one part of the flower, the male part of the flower, to the female part of the flower. It helps fertilize the flower and create a fruit. One of every three bites of our food that we have in our diet is thanks to pollinators. And without them, we would really not have the diversity that we enjoy today of the different types of food that we eat and the beautiful gardens that we have.
A lot of people are very uncomfortable with insects, being around them. But I think that if people actually gave them a little bit of space, watched what they were doing, and saw all that they actually provide for us, they'd have a little bit more respect for them.
I would say that the biggest draw to the exhibition of the Bug B&B in the Pollinator Garden is just that they're fun. We have these great sculptures that are larger than life, whimsical wooden natural materials.
In Bug B&B, I helped with the concepts of the insects themselves, which types of insects we would have, what type of information.
So behind me here, we have our beehive, and you can see it's wonderful, and people love to stop and take pictures. It's really interactive in a lot of ways. We were in there weeding one day, and I noticed that there was a group of teenagers that were walking through on some school field trip. And they said, oh my gosh, is that a mosquito? What is that? And I said, no, actually, it's a dragonfly. And what do you guys know about dragonflies? And it really prompted some conversations. And people that maybe wouldn't normally be interested in gardening or insects, it started those conversations and really inspired them to slow down and learn more about gardening and habitats and ask more questions and become more quizzical.
I really enjoyed getting to see the projects kind of come to life. We got to see these beautiful large-scale insects and just really highlight them in a fantastic way and be a part of putting that together.
I understand not all people are plant people, not all people appreciate plants, but people I think can appreciate animals and insects and birds, and especially here at the Pollinator Garden, people, when they see a huge bee or a giant praying mantis, they'll stop and say, wow, you know, this is really cool.
Our Habitat exhibition series will be on display through December of 2020, so it will be exciting to see how they age and continue interaction with our public.